Hi, I'm Julio Elizalde, Artistic Director of the Olympic Music Festival, and thanks for joining us for our final concert of the 2021 summer season. I'm very lucky to be joined by the final teacher I had at the Juilliard School in New York, Robert McDonald, or as we lovingly know him as Bob. Bob and I have known each other now. I think we're coming up on 14 years since I first had a chance to work with him at his summer festival in Taos, New Mexico. And ever since then, I've been learning an enormous amount. And as a professional, I still am inspired by his work ethic and his dedication, his selfless dedication to music. So I thought by having him here, we could share a mixture of four-hand pieces for one piano, four hands, and then some solo works that I think will also be really interesting to listen to. The first piece on tonight's program is by Mozart, and this is a piece that actually many people are not familiar with, and I would even say many pianists are not familiar with, mostly because it's not exactly written for our instrument, but it's possible to play it on our instrument. It seems that Mozart had a benefactor or a supporter, a count, Joseph Daim, who seems to have had a fascination with mechanical clocks. And especially mechanical clocks or timepieces that could be, I guess, programmed, if you will, to play an organ. This piece is called The Fantasy in F Minor for Mechanical Organ. And it is unbelievable because it is one of his later pieces. When you look at the catalog of numbers for Mozart that we usually keep track of, once it's above 600, we're really reaching the final years of his life. And this is K608. And this is a piece that's kind of in three movements, but they're all interconnected. It's a really just beautiful, beautiful piece. I'm so lucky to have played it, and Bob and I had a really great time working on it. I have to say that in this version that we played that was arranged by Paul Badura-Skoda, it is fiendishly difficult because we are constantly overlapping, and you'll see in some of the video how we have to get out of each other's way quickly and also lead from one of our hands to the other person's hands to get all of the music to connect seamlessly. But it's a wonderful piece of music. I'm sure it'll be a discovery for you, and as much as it was for us. So enjoy Mozart's Fantasy in F Minor for a Mechanical Organ, arranged for four-hand piano by Paul Badura-Skoda. Thank you.
First of all, I just want to say that it's a great pleasure to be here at this festival, and at this point, it's probably the fourth or fifth time that I've been a part of the end of the season here, with often many colleagues that I value greatly, younger colleagues usually, and this time it holds a sort of special a place in my heart because Julio asked me to come out, and instead of the normal chamber music format, we're doing this program of a combination of forehand works and solo literature. So the first thing that I'm playing today on the program is Beethoven's Sonata Opus 109. The work was composed in 1820, and it is pretty much part of what we consider or regard as the last triumvirate of his sonata output. And this work, along with the two that follow, Opus 110 and Opus 111, they share a similar kind of effort on Beethoven's part to reach for something in terms of the spirituality in what he heard or felt that music could express. The first movement has, for something as short as it is, it has a tremendous amount of contrast to it. And that is followed by a very, very compact and tense scherzo, also equally short in, and certainly the impact of it in terms of its ferocity is notable. So I hope you will enjoy the journey that this piece provides.
Thank you.
This year, the Olympic Music Festival is counting on listeners like yourself, because every year we usually offset our expenses by having ticket sales. And since we couldn't really do public performances in the normal way we hope to, ticket sales are not there, and they're a really critical part of our budget for when it comes to inviting artists, moving pianos, housing people, feeding people. It takes a lot to put on a music festival and to have all of these beautiful performances come to life. This year, a generous donor is offering to match every dollar we raise up to $50,000. So your donation of $100 will have the impact of $200. We hope you'll take advantage of this to help us keep the music moving, keep it alive, and especially as we hope in 2022 we'll be able to have an in-person, safe season back here in Port Townsend. So for anything that you can do to help us, please visit olympicmusicfestival.org. Every dollar counts. And if you can't donate, we hope you'll at least just share it with your friends and family. Share this video or share the concert page where all of the videos are available. We want to make this music go as wide and worldwide as possible. We make it free so that as many people can enjoy it as possible. So for all of your help, we thank you. I'm going to be playing a couple of pieces by Frédéric Chopin. One is a mazurka, and the other is the bark roll. Now, mazurka might be familiar to some of you, but mazurkas are Polish dances, and Chopin, although he seems to be associated with France, he was Polish, and he was forced to leave his home due to political unrest, and so many artists and painters and philosophers and composers and musicians were displaced out of Poland. Chopin had hoped to move to London, but that never came to be, and he ended up in France. And I think the mazurka was a way for him to reconnect with his home. And this piece in particular, the mazurka in C sharp minor, is a piece that's full of kind of tragedy and sorrow. It's an unusually profound piece. The mazurkas are dances in 3/4 time, very much like a waltz, but there's a stylistic difference. When you listen to a waltz, you'll hear the cha-cha, cha-cha. In mazurkas, it's a little bit stylized so that you hear the second beat early, so cha-cha, cha-cha. You'll hear it during the piece, but this piece is so emotional, and there are moments where I almost think you can feel a singer singing through tears. It's very painful, but at the same time very beautiful. And immediately after that mazurka, I'm going to play what many pianists consider to be his most profound work, the barcarolle in F sharp major. The barcarolle is a Venetian gondola song, and so you can hear at the beginning of the barcarolle the kind of the movement of the water as a gondola passes over it. You can hear the song of the gondolier, and the romanticism of the entire piece is just overwhelmingly beautiful. But one curious thing that I like to point out is the opening of the piece, because in the early 20th century and even in the late 19th century, concert pianists had a tradition of improvising between pieces. And I think it's a tradition that's been lost now, but you can imagine Chopin using the first note, which is a C sharp, which is the same note as the mazurka, and then finding a way to perhaps melt into the new key of F sharp major for the barcarolle. I think it's a window into what his improvisational abilities were, and it's a really profound way to change keys. I think you'll hear it when the barcarolle begins, but both of these pieces are really special to me, and I'm glad to share them with you now.
Thank you.
So W.C. wrote two books of preludes for the piano. Each contained 12 individual pieces. I'm going to play four from the first book. This was published in 1910. And often the subject matter that W.C. draws upon comes from literary inspirations. Sometimes it's to do with the natural world. Other times it's to do with particular individuals that he's trying to personify in an individual prelude. Today I've chosen The Hills of Anacapri, the What the West Wind Has Seen, The Girl with the Flaxen Hair, and finally, The Sunken Cathedral.
Thank you. Thank you.
So the last work on the program is a genuine charmer, and it is a kind of a picture that Fauré paints of domestic life in a household that he was very much a part of, friends of the family. The singer, who was extremely well known in her time, named Emma Bardach, had two children. One was a little girl named Dolly, and she had an older brother named Raoul. And basically, Fauré, in the six movements, he gives us a kind of a wonderful sense of the spirit of this household. And some of this music may actually sound rather familiar to you, and some of it may not. It's certainly a piece that has earned its popularity over time, and I hope that we do justice to it.
Thank you so much for being with us today. It was a pleasure to share this music, especially working with Bob McDonald. I hope you enjoyed hearing him, and especially some of his beautiful solo pieces and then the forehand pieces that we worked on together. The 2021 summer season was made possible by viewers like yourself who believe in what we do, who continue to support it. Remember that you can visit our website, olympicmusicfestival.org, to watch all of the programs from this summer up until the end of October. They're available to you free of charge. Again, please share them with your friends, your family, anyone who loves music. We want as many people as possible to enjoy them. We're looking forward to coming back next season in person safely, and we can't wait to see you then. So until then, we hope you have a great fall. Stay safe, stay healthy, and thanks for supporting the Olympic Music Festival. Have a good night.